Look, yo be biting him like, bro.
He had his tail.
But for all of us, we want to thank you because you know what? And we also understand that you had started your podcast.
Yeah.
You had did your podcast. Yeah, but you need to stop that and come with Drink Champ Network.
I'm fucking with you. I did 59 episodes.
This is what we're doing. I'm Sheldon Knight and Puff Daddy together.
I love it.
If they had never had beef, if Chip Knight and Puff Daddy got together, this is what Drink Champ Network is. Let's make some noise. Come on, hey, did you get it? Thank you so much. Because you know why? There really isn't no other platform of hip hop.
No,
we give real talk. But not only that, we praise our legend.
Right.
Because every time in our game, after you get 10 years, you're finished.
Yeah.
And in every other music or genre or anything, after you get 10 years, you're a legend.
Well, come on, man.
When you get 10 years in hip hop, yeah, they say you old.
Yo, fuck it.
And we don't want to do that over here.
That's another place. You know, if I met George Clinton, and I know George Clinton, God from the money he got in his pockets, he's motherfucking George Clinton.
Absolutely.
And that's how, I'm not a disrespectful cat, man. These people are very
good. And just so you know, you are our George Clinton in hip hop.
Yeah,
you make some fucking noise. I ain't fucking see it. And not only that, you made it
for kids.
This my kids.
Bruh.
You got all of them, my children. All of them. They might not look like it, but they all my children.
That's Joe.
That's all my children. But
what's up,
you are the George Clinton of our
get him, Yogi.
And we're going to continue to praise you.
Come
and make sure we love you.
Thank you, man.
Goddamn. I see. Make some noise. Drink it.
It's like my little nephew right here, boy.
It's your boy N-O-R-E.
What up, it's DJ ESN.
And it's Drink Champ Network Podcast.
Make some noise!
And right now, it's an absolute honor for me to introduce this man. Not only is he one of my favorite rappers, he's also one of my favorite people. Like, the person that he is right now, I strive to be that. You know what I'm saying? As a person that who writes his own movies, produces his own movies, who you can tell he handpicks his roles. I do a lot of things in life, and I say, if Ice Cube ain't doing it, I ain't doing it. Like, I don't live like that, like in real life. So I'll be like, yo, somebody offered me a big park car. I'm like, I don't think the Cube ain't doing it. You know what I mean? So in life, I do that. So I'm so honored to have in the building with the Drink Champs. It's the first time hip-hop is controlling media. My brother, DJ EFN, is a DJ. I'm a hip-hop artist, and we transitioned, and we now in the journalistic point of view, and you got what? This is like a
baby.
God damn it, motherfucking West Coast legend Ice Cube. Who in the motherfucking building? Man, I appreciate it, man. That's love. I went to the premiere last night, and yeah, it was.
You have to stop talking about it.
That's when Yogi be like,
I'm going to bring my kids, I'm going to bring my wife, because the movie was hilarious from the beginning. Now, so when we speak about this movie, how did you get approached to this movie?
I've been working with New Line, thank you. I've been working with New Line for a minute. Mm-hmm. And,
I'm about to say, you about to knock
him
off. They said Charlie Day was attached to it, mm-hmm. And I've been wanting to work with Charlie for a minute, because mm-hmm. I think his form of comedy is unique, you know, and so I just knew if we ever did something together, it would be lit, mm-hmm. And, you know, it all came together, you know, the director is a guy that he worked with,
wow.
You know, on Always Sunny, he shot
episodes
of that,
wow.
So, you know, the synergy was right, the role was right, and, you know, we came out here and did our thing, we shot it out in Atlanta.
Right, And then you got Tracy Morgan. The return of Tracy Morgan is in this.
Yeah.
And he's funny as fuck. Yeah. Like, oh my God. Like, you like, because sometimes, you know, when a person goes through a tragic accident, you almost feel like that it's something gonna be different about him, but he was straight up chasing the money, and it was hilarious.
Yeah, you know, it was just good to see that dude.
Right.
I had worked with him before on First Sunday. Did a movie together.
That's right, First Sunday, y'all were in church.
He had an ankle bracelet on his ankle. You know,
like in real life?
In real life. Oh, my God. After we shot, he had to go straight to the hotel. And, you know, he said, man, doing that movie, you know, I really thought about it. I got my life together after that. So it was cool to see him, you know, on the other side of this accident and, right. You know, just a happy guy. You know,
healthy and still being funny.
Healthy and happy, yeah.
So now I'm going to be a little bit all over the place because this is something that it hit me crazy when I watched Straight Outta Compton.
Yeah.
Well, let it go.
Comes over to you and says, how is Friday coming along?
Yeah.
So.